Hi, I'm Sean Burke. I'm the program manager for the Infantry Squad opportunity here. Behind me is the Polaris ISV Dagor, so that we're teamed together with to propose to the United States Army. We're in a competition phase right now with two other vendors and looking to deliver prototypes next month. The Polaris has decades of off-road performance, and SAIC being an integrator for the government, we bring engineering and ability to kind of navigate the acquisition process for the Army. So we're teamed together and looking forward to proposing a winning solution for the Army. Mobility and maneuver for the infantry squad and an IBCT, so move soldiers around the battlefield. So that big requirements are it needs to be less than 5,000 pounds and needs to move a whole infantry squad and their gear. So that's kind of the key requirements. And the transportability of the vehicle will be key, so that's why you need the smaller size and the lower weight. So, you know, taking their pedigree and their design to meet those key requirements, so it's kind of a commercial platform, but then to apply, there's certain mil standards that still need to be met. So we're making a few modifications to meet those key military requirements and give the Army what they're asking for. You know, a big message is that I think the vehicle here meets their key requirements. You know, there's always room for improvement. So in this prototyping phase, we're making the changes. We recently, in the prototyping runoff, we had soldiers on it, so we did get some feedback from the soldiers, what they liked, didn't like, and so we're making some adjustments to kind of better meet what they need to perform their mission on the battlefield. So.
Well, the U.S. Army has got an acquisition plan for how they want to go forward with ISV, and as we looked at some of the initial requirements for that and their plan, we felt that we needed a partner sophisticated in the defense business, one that had the systems engineering and the systems management to support all the needs that the Army would have to field such a program. SAIC came up as a terrific partner, and so we decided to join, knowing that that would be the best chance for us to go forward on our Dagor ISV. The Dagor has been fielded within DoD and a few allies as well, in particularly both elements of U.S. SOCOM and the Army, the 82nd Airborne Division, all have Dagors. I would say we currently have a Dagor that is the modern version or the latest version, and then to get it to the configuration the Army wants for their infantry squad vehicle, the ISV, we've created an upfit package to provide those additional requirements for, like, the seating for dying passengers, rear rollover protection, enhanced ingress egress with a rear tactical ladder, things like that. So that gets it from our Dagor A1 off the production line to a Dagor ISV. The Dagor has been constructed, designed to perform an extreme off-road performance. So that's the number one criteria. And then it has to be highly transportable. So the Dagor fits in the Army CH-47 and can also be sling load under a UH-60 or airdropped out of strategic assets from the Air Force. And that's the second criteria. The third criteria is the modular open architecture that Dagor provides, which allows the Army to seat up to 9 or use it for hauling other things. It's configurable in a number of different applications, including to CASEVAC or rescue, things like that. The SAIC Polaris team, we think, brings forth the best from both companies. We're the world's leading off-road manufacturer, and SAIC is one of the leading defense contractors, and we think that together we provide the best option for a winning solution for the Army ISV and offering the Dagor.